Hello, my name is Dr. Greg Simcoe. Another pattern or illness that can affect the hypothalamus, which then affects the entire hypothalamus pituitary thyroid axis or system, is a chronic illness. and chronic illnesses, or when you have an illness of any kind and when your immune system is activated, you produce cytokines. Cytokines are just basically a hormone that goes into your system and helps it fight things, supposedly. Now, cytokines actually have a dampening effect on the hypothalamus. The hypothalamus is important in the axis because it produces hormones to tell the pituitary to produce TSH. If it's not doing that, the pituitary is not going to produce so much TSH. So cytokines dampen the activity of the hypothalamus pariventricular cells. Now, the immune system, usually when there is increased cytokines, the immune system is under chronic stress. Chronic stress being anything that are chronic illnesses, such as Lyme disease, hepatitis, any type of autoimmune disease can actually impact the hypothalamus adversely, such as lupus or rheumatoid arthritis or MS or Hashimoto's disease is an autoimmune disease. So when the immune system is out of balance and being attacked or overstressed, it produces these cytokines that then suppress the hypothalamus. So it's very important to find out if indeed this is happening. And the immune system needs to be supported. And there's ways of supporting the immune system. And an autoimmune system, in other words, your own body is attacking your cells, there's ways of calming that down and supporting that. It's very important to find these things out because not only are an individual fighting this foreign substance in their body, but they're also causing parts of their body to start functioning abnormally. So a vicious cycle occurs because if the hypothalamus is not producing what it should in order for the thyroid gland to produce what it should, the immune system becomes further compromised because the thyroid gland influences the immune system. So you see how everything kind of fits together. So if you have one problem, it can actually cause many other problems. So it's very important not to look at just one little piece of someone. It's important to look at the whole picture. What is happening to the whole body? I like to say to patients that, you know, your problems are not chapters. Whether you have an issue with your knee or your thyroid gland or your back or your eye, whatever, usually there's something causing these things. So you need to say, why? Why am I having these symptoms? Why is this low? Why is my immune system out of whack? Yes, I have an infection, but why am I not able to fight that infection? All these things are important to look at to help you be able to understand and help your clinician understand what you should do about it. And not just giving antibiotics and not just saying, okay, take this or take that, because you have to understand why are you taking these things? Why are you taking antibiotics? Why do you have to take them? Why do you have to take this vitamin? Why do I have to do this diet? Why? And those are important questions that need to be asked in order for you to fully get to the root of what is going on. So your clinician has to fully understand what the problem is. And that's what you need to look for.